We spoke last time about how root is the same numerical value as dibata, you have spoken, and it's the same numerical value as the letters that spell out the word Adov Shem, like Aleph, Dalet, Nun, Yud, but the filling in letters to spell out the word Aleph, to spell out the word Dalet, to spell out the word Nun, and to spell out the word Yud. The filling in letters together, they spell out the same gematria as Rut, which is 606. Right? Remember this? Now, the word Adoshem, like Aleph, Dalet, Nun, Yud, it has the numerical value of 65. So 65 is also something very interesting, which is in this reading that we read today, we see that Ruth is cleaving to Naomi, but Orpah is splitting off, going back home to Moab, going back to her people and her God. And so the question, you know, is what that very pivotal moment of where Ruth and Orpah's way split, what are the consequences of that? And this is what I always tell students, that you know, you have a decision before me. I had once a student who came to convert, and at some point in the middle of the process she just said, no, I'm going back home, it's too hard, it's too this, I don't have any more money. And so, and I told her, look, what happened to Ruth and Orpah? They were both going together. One became the mother of who? Of David, of the Mashiach. And what did the other one become the mother of? They were at a crossroad, one took left and one took right. That little step, that little inch of a difference between the directions of these two women made the whole difference of the world. What happened to Orpah? Who did she become the mother of? Goliath. Like this complete contrast, just because of one step in the opposite direction. Now B'nai Yisachar says something, you know, to support that, and even deeper. And B'nai Yisachar says, it's mentioned, Orpah is mentioned in another place, in the book of Shmuel. Anyone who wants can find it. The second book of Shmuel, chapter 21, verse... verse 16. And there, instead of Orpah, she's called Horpah. The iron is exchanged into a hay. She's called Horpah. If anyone can see, they talk about the sons of Horpah. Anyone found it? Because I think that it's written one way and it's read another way. So what is the, you found it, Atar? The second book of Shmuel, chapter 21, verse 16. So she's called here Halpa instead of Orpa, which the regular way of spelling her is like this. And here, there's a difference between the iron and the hay. All the other letters are the same. But what's the numerical difference between iron and hay?
65.
Okay. What does that teach us? What is that number 65 that I just mentioned? What did we say 65 was? The name of God. Aleph is 1, Dalet is 4, so that's already 5. Then Nun is 50 and Yud is 10, so there we got the 60. 60 plus 5 is 65. So what happens? Orpah turns into Horpah. Horpah. You found it?
It's 2160?
Yes.
Okay. That doesn't make sense.
Yes. Let's see. No, Shmuel Bet, you're in Shmuel Aleph. Shmuel Bet, 21, 16. Shmuel Bet,
the Yeliden Harfa. Okay? Harfa. Hey, Vaish Harafa. Okay, and so if you look at the commentaries there, they say this was Orpa. And now she's losing 65, number 65 from her name. Why? Because those sparks of Hashem's name that was in her, Rut took them when Orpah decided to turn her back on her mother-in-law. And last time we were talking about the names and the meaning of each of the people's name. And what does Orpah mean? When we talked about how Elimelech means, to me is kingdom. Or like, it could, or God is my king. You can understand it two ways. Naomi means what? Who remembers?
Why is it considered she turned her back when she was told by Naomi to go?
Okay, 1 second. Okay, that's a good question. Excellent question. No, what does Naomi mean? Just a little review. Pleasant, sometimes really, you know, kind and giving to everybody, and sometimes the flip side, people pleaser. Not enough backbone to stand up for what she believes in. We talked about machlon and chilion. Machlon can mean forgiving. It can mean, or it could mean sickness, or it can mean forgiveness, like mechila. And chilion can mean or completion or destruction. So like we talked about how each name can mean opposite things. And that each name is the essence of who you are. You have a choice before you. What you want to do with your life. So Ruth and Orpah both had a holiness in them. They were not converted. They were Moabite women that, you know, these holy Judean tribes married without converting them, but still there was something special about them. Who were they, by the way? According to the Midrash, who were they, the daughters of? The daughter of the king of Moab, the Midrash says. They were princesses. And it was very special that they even wanted to leave their home and their princesship and, you know, and all that, whatever amazing, great life they could have over there, to follow Naomi to a strange land, to a people they didn't know. They didn't know if they're going to be accepted by. And so it was already very special because they were holy women. But then, the whole process here, this whole process of how Naomi turns them back, and she's, and I'm going to try to answer your question here, she keeps turning them back, is where we learn from also, you have to turn a convert back three times. There's actually, if you look at it, you'll see it three times that she tells them, go back, go back, go back. But at the same time as she's doing that, according to Al-Sheikh, there's two levels going on at the same time. And this would also be amazing in a play, to play that out. You have to be a really good actress. Do you know how, when sometimes you say something with your words and something else with your body language? Like, she's, the same time she's telling them to go back, she really wants them to come with her. That's what he says. And we're going to see there are hints of that.
Who says that?
Like, for example, she says, Lech Nashovna. Which pasuk is that? Who can find that? Lech Nashovna. Which means, go, return. So according to Ashik, it means go, come with me. Or go away and then return. No, but come back with me. Come back with me. And she's saying two opposite things. She really wants them to come, but she wants them to really come because they want to come, not because they, because, you know, they. And she wants to show that how much resistance, you know, that's how Hashem tests us a lot of times. She wants to see how much we still want to go with him, even if we get a lot of resistance. When you turn away a convert, you really hope that the convert will have enough backbone and be strong enough to come anyway, even if he's turned away. No? You see that? Lech Nashovna? Who found that pasuk? Perek Aleph, pasuk. Let me see.
8.
Okay, very good. Lech Nashovna, excellent. So we see here that there's like a double language. She's looking for the holiness in these girls. In order to get the holiness, she has to turn them back to get rid of the inholy, impurity. To see like all the negativity and all the part that is not connected with Kedusha of a Jewish woman, this is what she's turning away. But she hopes that there's going to be a kernel of Kedusha, of holiness there. And that's why Opa, what it means, in that she didn't withstand that test. She just listened to the exterior words, go, go, go. And she went, and so she did turn her back, literally, like she reversed. She was going with Naomi, she was doing something good, and then she turned back. And okay, and it seems very harsh, because it's a very harsh outcome because of that. Like, Naomi told her to go, so what did she do so wrong? But because she had the opportunity to come to Naomi, to become Jewish, and she didn't take the opportunity, that's what I told this girl. Oh,
it says right here that she went back, I just read it.
Afterwards, Naomi's...
She's gone back to her people and to her gods.
Right, that's what Naomi tells Ruth. How does Naomi know that? You could say, well, maybe she would go back to her people